Very good morning, students. Sai Ram. Welcome back to our science period. So, children, you know very well now which one is going on. Revision is going on, isn't it? So, for your unit test, you are having two lessons for your science B. That is classification of plants and energy flow in an ecosystem. Classification of plants revision was over. Now, which one is going on? Energy flow in an ecosystem. Okay, so last session we discussed about what is mean by ecosystem, and the next one is what is mean by food chain, food web, and example also we discussed. And next one what we studied? Yes, energy pyramid. Okay, so these all things we discussed. So this session I am going to teach you about biogeochemical cycle. Okay, what is mean by biogeochemical cycle and what are the types, what is the importance of biogeochemical cycle, these all things we are going to discuss in this session. Okay, are you ready, children? Shall I start? What is mean by biogeochemical cycle? See here, the cyclical flow of nutrients within an ecosystem is called the biogeochemical cycle. Okay, so what is mean by biogeochemical cycle? Can you say? Yes, very good. Cyclical flow of nutrients within an ecosystem. You know very well what is meant by ecosystem. That means biotic and abiotic organisms. That means living and non-living organisms is interconnected. Okay, the interaction between living things and non-living things, that is called the ecosystem. And the cyclical flow of nutrients within an ecosystem is called the biogeochemical cycle. Okay, next one is, yes, types of biogeochemical cycle. There are two types. First one is gaseous cycle and next one is sedimentary cycle. Okay, yeah, what is meant by gaseous cycle and sedimentary cycle? We will see one by one. So first one is gaseous cycle. An accumulation of the main abiotic gaseous nutrient. Okay, so children, see here, an accumulation of the, what is meant by gaseous cycle, an accumulation of the main abiotic gaseous nutrient materials is found in the earth's atmosphere. You know where is that earth's atmosphere? Yes, our surrounding. So that accumulation of the main abiotic, yes, gaseous nutrient materials is found in where? Earth's atmosphere. Includes nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, water vapor, etc. So these all things are present in where? This nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide is present in where? Yes, atmosphere. Okay, next one is what? Sedimentary cycle. An accumulation of the, yes, sedimentary means what? Settled down. An accumulation of the main abiotic nutrient materials is found in soil, sediment and sedimentary rocks. Yes, in gaseous cycle, that gaseous nutrient are, yes, accumulated in where? Earth's atmosphere. But here, this all nutrient materials is found in soil, sediment and sedimentary rocks. That's why it is called sedimentary cycle, okay, of the earth. Includes soil components like iron, calcium and phosphorus, etc. Okay, so children, when you are studying here, you have to compare and study. Okay, next one is, see here, what is the importance of biogeochemical cycle? Biogeochemical cycles are important because they regulate the elements. Why it is important? Yes, they regulate, that biogeochemical cycle regulate the elements, which element? That is necessary for the life on earth, by cycling them through the biological and physical aspect of the world. So with the help of this biogeochemical cycle, that is that important nutrients, okay, important nutrients are regulated for life on earth by cycling them through the biological and physical aspect of the world. So with the help of this biogeochemical cycle only, we are getting enough amount of oxygen and other elements from our atmosphere, from our earth. Biogeochemical cycles are a form of natural recycling that allows the continuous surviving of, yes, ecosystems. Okay, this is the one of the main importance of biogeochemical cycle. Understood, children? Shall I go to next? So without this biogeochemical cycles, that living organisms cannot survive on the earth. So with the help of this biogeochemical cycle only, that elements are regulating. Okay, regulate. We are getting that enough amount of, yes, elements from our earth. See here, climatic changes and human activities seriously affect the speed, intensity and equilibrium of these cycles. So which one is affecting? Yes, climatic changes. Climatic changes and human activities. Okay, seriously affect the speed, intensity and equilibrium of these cycles. Next one is, the gaseous cycle is speedier than the sedimentation cycle. So already I told two types of cycle, isn't it? Gaseous cycle and sedimentary cycle. Which one is speed? Yes, the gaseous cycle is speedier than the sedimentation cycle. For example, here one example is there. If carbon dioxide gas has accumulated in an area, it is quickly dispersed with the wind or absorbed by plants. So if that carbon dioxide has accumulated in an area, what will happen? It is quickly dispersed with the wind or absorbed by plants. So here which one is speedier? Yes, gaseous cycle is more speedier than the sedimentation cycle. Okay, for sedimentation it will take lot of time. Okay, next one is, in a gaseous cycle, elements move through the atmosphere. In a gaseous cycle, elements move through the atmosphere. Yes, gaseous cycle, as I told here, move through the atmosphere, gaseous. Okay, main reservoir are the atmosphere and the ozone. See here, what is the main reservoir of the gaseous cycle? Atmosphere and the ozone. Next one is, in a sedimentary cycle, elements move from the land to water, that means lithosphere to hydrosphere. Main reservoirs are the soil and sedimentary rocks. Understood, children? Yes. Next one is, see here, the cycle of gases and the sedimentary cycle cannot be completely separated from each other. Okay, both are interconnected, that means both that depends on each other. The cycle of gases and the sedimentary cycle cannot be completely separated from each other. So children, for example here, nitrogen is present in the form of a gas in the atmosphere and in the form of compounds like nitrogen oxide in the soil and sediments. Already I told that both cycles are, yes, we cannot separate each other. For example here, nitrogen is where it is present. Yes, nitrogen, 78% of nitrogen is present in our atmosphere. So nitrogen is present in the form of a gas in the atmosphere. At the same time, this nitrogen is present in the compounds like nitrogen oxide in the soil and sediments. So nitrogen is present in atmosphere, at the same time it is present in the soil also. Okay, next one is, yes, another example is here. Carbon occurs in abiotic form mainly in, yes, coal, granite, diamond, limestone, etc. Okay, these all present in where? Yes, soil, in the earth's crust and in the form of carbon dioxide gas in the atmosphere. So, at the same time, this carbon is present in atmosphere. At the same time, this carbon is present in earth's crust also in the form of coal, granite, diamond, limestone, etc. Okay, so nitrogen is present in atmosphere. At the same time, lithosphere, like that, carbon also present in our atmosphere in the form of carbon dioxide. And it is present in soil, that means earth's crust, in the form of coal, granite, diamond, limestone. Okay, so children, understood? So children, I hope you understood now what is meant by biogeochemical cycle and what are the types of biogeochemical cycle, and now what we studied, yes, importance of biogeochemical cycle. Okay, shall I go to next? Next one is, yes, these three biogeochemical cycle we are going to discuss. Okay, in this session I am going to discuss only carbon cycle. Remaining two cycle I will revise on next session. Okay, carbon cycle, what is mean by carbon cycle and what are the steps of carbon cycle, we will see now. So carbon cycle means the circulation and recycling of carbon. See here, circulation and recycling of carbon from the atmosphere to living organisms and after their death back to the atmosphere is called the carbon cycle. So carbon cycle means the circulation and recycling of carbon That's what is called what? Carbon cycle. Okay. So the circulation and recycling of carbon from where to where? Yes, from the atmosphere. From the atmosphere, it will go to the living organisms. Okay. So after the death of these living organisms, again it go to, yes, back to the atmosphere. So this is cyclic flow manner. That's why it is called a carbon cycle. So understood now what is meant by carbon cycle? Circulation and recycling of carbon from the atmosphere to living organisms. After the death of living organisms, where it will go? Again, it will go to the atmosphere. So this is cyclical manner. That's why we are saying this is a carbon cycle. Okay. So abiotic carbon atoms are circulated and recycled into biotic form mainly through photosynthesis. How it is? Yes, how it is flowing through the photosynthesis? You know very well what is meant by photosynthesis and respiration. Okay, so hence this carbon cycle is one of the important biogeochemical cycle. Why it is important? Yes, abiotic carbon atoms are circulated and recycled into biotic form mainly through two processes, that is photosynthesis and respiration. We will see now what is meant by photosynthesis and respiration. Okay, so this is one of the important biogeochemical cycle. Now we will discuss about steps of carbon cycle. What exactly will happen in this carbon cycle? First, see here, plants convert carbon dioxide into carbohydrates by the process of photosynthesis. See here, children. So children, this is the first step. Plants convert carbon dioxide into carbohydrates, okay, by the process of photosynthesis. So during photosynthesis, what exactly it will happen? Yes, with the help of that sunlight, in the presence of chlorophyll and with the help of carbon dioxide, plants convert that carbon dioxide into carbohydrate, that means glucose, their food, okay, by the process of photosynthesis. Next one, what will happen? Yes, herbivores feed upon plants. Who will take that plants? Who will eat plants? Herbivores. Already we studied. Next one is, who will eat this herbivore? Yes, it is eaten by carnivores. Carnivores feed upon herbivores. Okay, and the next one is, in this way, biotic carbon is transported from plants to herbivores. Plants to herbivores, from herbivores to carnivores, from carnivores to apex consumers. Okay, so that carbon is transported from where to where? Plants to herbivores, from herbivores to, it will go to carnivores, from the carnivores it will go to the apex consumers. So from this apex consumers, where it will go, where this carbon will transport? Okay, just you have to see here. Next one. So after death, already I told that apex consumer, no one will eat that apex consumer. Okay, so after death, all type of consumer are decomposed by decomposers. So after death, all type of consumers are decomposed by which one? Yes, decomposers. Decomposers means nothing but that is like bacteria and fungi. And carbon dioxide is released again into the atmosphere and is used again by living organisms. Understood, children? So that plants are using that carbon dioxide, it is converted into a carbohydrate. So that carbohydrate, it will transfer from one traffic level to another traffic level. Okay, finally it will reach, yes, apex consumers. So afterwards, what will happen? After death, all type of consumers are decomposed by decomposers. Okay, this time that complex material is converted into a simple substance. That simple substance is easily mixed with soil. So from the soil, who will absorb? Yes, definitely plants will take. Okay, so fungi and carbon dioxide is released again into the atmosphere. So at the same time, that carbon dioxide is released to the atmosphere. So from the atmosphere, who will take? Yes, that nutrients, it is mixed with soil and carbon dioxide is mixed with atmosphere. So from the atmosphere, the plants are absorbing this atmosphere, that from that atmosphere, which one? Carbon dioxide. And the which, for which process? Photosynthesis process. Okay, so I hope you understood now. Shall I go to next one is, So in this way, carbon is continuously passed on from one living organism. I hope you understood now what are the steps of carbon cycle and what is meant by carbon cycle, isn't it? Shall I go to next, children? Yes, see here, this figure shows that, this diagram shows that carbon cycle. See here, I will explain here. Yes, this is atmospheric carbon dioxide. Okay, this is atmospheric carbon dioxide, and with in the presence of sunlight, plants are preparing their food. That process is called what? Photosynthesis. Okay, and who will take this? Yes, this, that energy we are taking, that means animals are taking from the plants. So when we are respiring here, we are releasing carbon dioxide over to the atmosphere. So from the atmosphere, who is taking this carbon dioxide? Again, plants are taking. Okay, so I hope you understood now. See here, children, this is the atmospheric carbon dioxide. So for photosynthesis process, plants are absorbing this carbon dioxide, and we are eating these plants, so we are getting energy. At the same time, when we respirate, that time carbon dioxide is released to the atmosphere. Again, that carbon dioxide is absorbed by plants. So this is the cyclical flow of manner, flow manner. Okay, so this is called what? Carbon cycle. Understood now? Yes. Shall I go to next? Next one is, see here, children, these two are the main important process of carbon cycle. First one is photosynthesis, next one is what? Yes, respiration. See here, what exactly will happen? I will teach you here. Yes, and first one is, this is carbon dioxide, 6CO2. That means carbon dioxide is combined with water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll. Sunlight, you know where it is present, and chlorophyll, it is present in the plants. Okay, so that carbon dioxide is combined with water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll gives what? Yes, plants are preparing their food. That is what? Glucose. That means carbohydrate. What is the molecular formula of carbohydrate? C6H12O6. Tell me once again, children, you have to study well. Okay, C6H12O6 plus, that means carbohydrate, plus which one is forming as a byproduct here? Water and oxygen. That means carbon 6H2O plus 6O2. So that photosynthesis process means what? That carbon dioxide is combined with water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll, glucose, that means carbohydrate, is formed, plus water and oxygen also released to the atmosphere. So next one is what? Respiration. Okay, so who is taking this oxygen from the atmosphere? Yes, we are taking during the respiration process. So we are taking that oxygen during that respiration process. That time, see here, this, yes, this carbohydrate is combined with oxygen to form the energy. So at the same time, we are releasing what? Carbon dioxide to the atmosphere. So who will take this carbon dioxide? Again, plants are absorbing this carbon dioxide in which process? Photosynthesis process. So like this way, carbon is, yes, flowing from, yes, the cyclical flow of manner. Okay, the cyclical flow, that carbon is, yes, from atmosphere to the living organisms, from living organisms to the atmosphere. That's why it is called carbon cycle. So children, this session about the biogeochemical cycles, their types, and the importance of biogeochemical cycle. And in your textbook, 3 biogeochemical cycles are there. First one is what? Carbon cycle, that we discussed, isn't it? And which two are remaining? That is oxygen cycle and nitrogen cycle. That 2 cycle I will teach you in next session. Understood, children? So I hope you understood now. Thank you, children. Sairam.